So, hello Rohini, how are you?
Fine.
Okay, so don't get nervous today, okay?
Yes.
And even if you don't know the answer, so we are over here to help you out.
Okay. Okay. No problem.
So tell us something about what things you will check when you are doing database testing.
Database testing.
Let's say if there is an application and you are supposed
Yes.
to check all the things with the database are working fine or not. So what all things you will check in that? Just the high level scenarios.
No, sir.
Okay, let me tell you. So first is the database connectivity that you can check. Another thing is the
Okay.
required application field and its size. Then you can check about the stored procedures, what is the functional flow, what are the DML operations, whether they are getting performed properly or not. All these things you can check in database testing. Okay.
Okay.
Then what do you mean by one of the, let's take one of the OOPS concept, inheritance in Java.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah, what is the meaning of inheritance in Java? What is inheritance?
And inheritance is a any acquires of class all properties and behaviors of parent class of objects using inheritance interface between two class or two models.
Right.
Okay.
So it is
And
actually,
in
yeah, please go ahead.
yeah
Please go ahead.
in inheritance using the extends codes and inheritance multi types, single inheritance, multiple inheritance, hybrid inheritance.
Right.
There are types of inheritance.
Right. So basically, inheritance is one of the object-oriented feature which allows a
Okay.
class to inherit behavior and data from other class using extends
Yeah,
keyword
sir.
that you mentioned it
Yeah.
very right. And you can take an example of a class car, which can inherit the basic features, can extend basic features of vehicle class, by using
Okay. Right,
inheritance.
right.
And one of the most
Yes.
popular example is in
Car.
the real world is father-son relationship, where son
Yeah, sir.
inherits
Father
father's
and
property.
child relation.
So what is the difference between polymorphism and inheritance?
Okay. In polymorphisms, one task performed in different ways. Okay. And inheritance is two models, interface between two models.
Right.
And
So over here in polymorphism, you can choose which code to run at runtime by overriding. That is one of the difference.
okay, yeah, run time and
Yeah, runtime.
compile.
Okay, now let me ask one question. Can a class extend more than one class in Java?
Yes, sir.
Let's say there
One
is a
class.
class, and can it extend more than one class in Java?
Using extend words, create a two class.
Yeah, but more than one class,
And
is it possible? It would extend one class. Okay.
no possible.
Yeah, perfect answer. More than one class is not possible. Okay,
Okay.
because by default, at least they will extend one of the class, that is java.lang.object class in Java. Okay, but more than one class is not possible. So this was a
Not
tricky,
possible.
confusing question which I had asked you, and you answered it
Yes,
very
sir,
right.
yeah, right.
Yeah, you answered it very
Yeah,
right,
I
right?
am confusing this
Yeah.
question.
Yeah, no problem. No, don't get confused. The interviewer will confuse you in this manner.
Yeah,
Even
sir.
if you will tell no at the first step, no is the right answer. If you will tell at the very first beginning,
Yeah.
then also they'll tell you, are you sure? Do you want to think more on it like that? But you should stick to your answer. Your answer is right. No.
Yeah.
Now, What will happen if a class extends two interfaces and they both have a method with the same name and signature?
Can possible?
Yeah. Do you want me to repeat the question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what will happen if a class extends two interfaces and they both have a method with the same name and the signature? Let's say if there is one class and it is extending two interfaces, okay, and both the interfaces have got the same method, I mean the method with the same name and signature, then what would happen in this case? When you will run the program or when you will execute the program, then what would happen?
No, sir. No idea, sir.
So let me, yeah, no problem. See, in such cases, when the methods have same name and signature, you know, conflict will arise because the compiler will not be able to link the method call. So you'll get a compile time error in Java. So if you will try sometime in your programming, try to create two methods with the same two interfaces and both have same methods and same with the same name and signature, everything is same, then this compiler error will come. Okay, what is Confused. Encapsulation?
Okay, encapsulation, encapsulation, binding, binding, binding the, binding or wrapping the data and data together in a single units, like mobiles, and applications.
Right. So it is one of the object-oriented concept which is used to hide the internal details of a class. Okay. These are very important keywords. Hide the internal details of a class. Okay.
Okay.
So this you have to highlight in the answer, and you can also give the data like hash map encapsulate, how to store elements and how to calculate hash values. So that is also encapsulation. So that is one of the example or one of the other thing you can add to your definition. Now, can we override static method in Java?
In overriding. Called as a static static configuration, and overriding class method name are different, and class name and parameters are class name are same, but parameter are different. And in overriding, only static methods can be run this process.
So you are right. No, we cannot override a static method. That is not possible. Okay. So then you have to give the reasoning also, like because it is resolved at a compile time. Whenever there is a static method, it would get resolved at a compile time. Now, in order for overriding to work in such case, you know, a method should be virtual and should be resolved at runtime because objects would be available at runtime. But in this case, it is not possible. We cannot override a static method.
Yeah.
Now, multiple inheritance, you know, and understand this question very importantly. Is multiple inheritance supported by Java? First of all, yes or no?
Not supported in Java.
Right. Perfect answer. Okay. Now, why multiple inheritance is not supported by Java?
There are multiple class in a call to a parents. So compile time compiler are the confused which class first execute, and in parent class. So Java not supported multiple inheritance.
Right. See, actually multiple inheritance and all those things, you know, these were few of the features of C++. Okay. Now when Java got introduced, it got introduced after C++. So Java people did not wanted to take some of the C++ features which were confusing, and they are not that much essential also. So to avoid the complexity and confusion, they avoided taking multiple inheritance feature in Java.
Code base. Yes, sir.
Now what is multi-threading?
Multi-threading. No, sir. Cannot remind now, sir. Multi-threading.
Yeah, let me multi-threading. You know, multi-threading is nothing but a process of executing multiple threads simultaneously. Okay, it is used to obtain the multitasking thing, and it consumes less memory, and it gives a fast and efficient performance like that.
Okay. Okay.
So, what is the difference between hash set and tree set?
Okay,
hash
set and tree.
Both are similar. Both are confusing. This is also confusing question. If you can try and explain it. Yeah.
Hash set and tree set.
Tree set. Yeah.
Okay. Both are classes. Classes of object, and hash set and tree set extend to set interface, and tree set using the ascending orders, and hash set is no sir, cannot remember now difference.
So see, one of the differences, we will come to it. But see, the one of the common thing between them is they both implement set interface. Okay, whether it is hash set or it is preset, they both will implement set interface. Now hash set maintains no order, while preset maintains ascending order. Okay, so this can also be one of the question asked, like whether tree set maintains which order, ascending or descending. So you can answer it is ascending.
Ascending orders.
Yeah. Now hash set has got is more faster compared to tree set, and and hash set is backed up by hash map, while tree set is backed up by tree map, and hash set embedded by hash table, whereas tree set is implemented by tree structure. So these are all the differences that you can highlight, but one of the very important difference that I told you in the beginning were the initial. Hash set maintains no order, whereas tree set maintains ascending order. Hash set is more faster than tree set. It is more good to be implemented. Okay. Now, what is the difference between hash set and hash map?
Hash set and
hash map.
No, sir.
Okay. See, hash set contains only values, whereas hash map includes the entry key plus value pair. Hash set can be iterated also, while hash map needs to convert it into the set to be iterated. Now is it possible to synchronize array list?
Yes sir, possible synchronize array list.
Okay, can you tell only the method names, if you can recall? How can we synchronize array list in Java?
Okay. Method?
Method name or the function,
To add and delete?
No. To synchronize array list, I'm asking. So there are two methods. One is collections.synchronize list method. Another is copy on write array list. So these are actually, this is actually a question on Java collections.
So yeah, sir, Java collection.
Yeah. Okay. Now let's take a small break, and then we'll return back for Selenium questions.
Okay, no problem. Okay.